Welcome to part 10 of our developer tools guide. This time around, we're going to show you how to make quests in the editor, and we'll divide the subject into three episodes. First, we'll demonstrate how to place quest elements, or objects necessary for the quest creation. Then we'll devote the next episode to text implementation. And in the third video, we'll combine everything to form a simple quest with its own objectives. In our quest, the player will have the chance to loot some gear, while the main objective will be to defeat an enemy and recover a specific item. It's best to start with the spawn point, that is, the spot where the player will appear on the map. Each custom map has its own spawn point, called Map Start, which is the default starting point for the player. You can find it by locating a blue flag on the map. Alternatively, you can open the Objects window from the toolbar, find Map Start on the list, and double-click on it, as shown here. You can use spawn points to respawn the player after he dies also. To enable the respawn function to a spawn point, go to its attributes and select the checkbox M_respawn. Now, let's move the spawn point to a place where the gameplay on our map should begin. What the player will see after launching your map is crucial, so you should adjust it by changing the direction of the spawn point. Okay, now we can take care of the loot. The player will definitely need a medikit. First, go to the Assets window, choose Object Types, select the Item Spawner, and place it on the map. Now go to the attributes of the item spawner, find the field tabs, and choose the medikit from the list of available items. Alternatively, press the three dots button to open the list and type in the item name. Apart from specific items, you can also place a container with randomized content. To demonstrate, let's place a chest that, among other things, will have crafting parts inside. To do that, select the container and check tools_box on the type list. When you put containers on the map, you need to place their pivot properly on the ground. Otherwise, the opening animation may be displayed incorrectly. Remember to rotate the objects so that the Z-axis will be accessible to the player in the game. Now we can add some challenge to the map. So let's spawn a new quest item and its guardian. First, we place a spawner for the AI. To get the item, the player will have to defeat this enemy. We can change the enemy type and give him a unique name in the attributes window, as shown here. When the AI is there, we can finally place an item for the player to recover. All items that the player is required to collect are called quest items. This is a separate group of items than those found in the item spawner. By definition, quest items are singular, unique objects that are not commonly available in the game, unlike medikits, weapons, or crafting parts. In our case, the quest item is a wallet. To place it on the map, first we need to open the assets window, go to the meshes section, and search for it. Now, we only have to change its class to Quest Inventory Item DI. You'll find this option at the top of the attributes window. Okay, the last thing to do is to check all the quest elements are working properly in the game. The container and the medikit, check. Zombie, check. And the wallet, check. So there we go. Everything seems to work right. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out the next episode about quest editing.